is a vital organ responsible for many of the essential functions of life. Unfortunately, there are several problems that can happen that threatens its important roles. In this video, we will list the functions of the liver and explain the causes, symptoms, and complications of hepatitis and fatty liver. Let's first discuss the many functions of the liver. The liver is your main metabolic organ as it plays a central role in all metabolic processes in the body. The liver's main job is to filter the blood coming from the digestive tract before passing it to the rest of the body. A healthy liver is critical for nutrition. The liver is responsible for producing important proteins like those needed for red blood cells, albumin, and blood clotting. It is one of the organs that breaks down old and damaged blood cells. The liver helps metabolize carbohydrate, fat, and protein in order for them to be used for energy. With fat metabolism, the liver is responsible for bile production and excretion. The liver can make and store glycogen and certain vitamins and minerals. And the liver also detoxifies and excretes chemicals, cholesterol, hormones, and drugs. There are two main conditions that affect normal function of the liver: hepatitis and fatty liver. Each of these conditions can progress into liver disease known as cirrhosis. Fatty liver is just as it sounds, an accumulation of fat in the liver. If it is not resolved, it can lead to inflammation, scarring, and cirrhosis. Alcohol is the leading cause of problems with the liver. Just one episode of binge drinking can cause excess fat accumulation in the liver. However, that is easily reversed if the individual stops drinking and restores adequate nutrition. On the other hand, chronic alcohol abuse leads to a more serious form of fat buildup known as fatty liver disease. Alcohol is not the only cause of fatty liver disease, though. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is associated more with obesity, poor diet, and inactivity. Most individuals with fatty liver likely have no symptoms and may not even know they have it. However, as the condition advances, it can lead to digestive problems, bruising, fatigue, and jaundice. People with simple fatty liver don't have inflammation or scarring in the liver. However, as mentioned before, it can advance to inflammation, scarring, and cirrhosis. The next condition of the liver is hepatitis, which is simply an inflammation of the liver. It can progress to scarring and cirrhosis. There are several potential causes of hepatitis, including alcohol toxicity, a virus, medication, or fat accumulation, as we just discussed with fatty liver. Viral hepatitis is one of the leading causes. There are three primary types of viral hepatitis, A, B, and C. While hepatitis A is usually transmitted by food and goes away on its own, hepatitis B and C tend to be long-term problems and are mostly caused by contaminated blood, semen, and other body fluids through unprotected sex, tattoo needles, blood transfusions, and drug needles. There is a vaccine for hepatitis B that most healthcare workers with direct patient contact are required to receive. Acute hepatitis generally does not cause permanent liver damage. However, it can easily and rapidly lead to malnutrition because of the insult of the infectious process coupled with inadequate food intake. When hepatitis evolves into a chronic state, the nutritional status is usually relatively normal until it progresses to end-stage liver disease, which often takes 10 to 20 years. A very distinct symptom of liver disease is jaundice, which is a yellowing of the skin caused by bilirubin buildup in the blood. With jaundice, the whites of the eyes will also turn yellow. Hepatitis is considered acute during the first 6 months of the illness. If it is not resolved by 6 months, it is then considered a chronic disease. Liver disease progresses through three stages: inflammation, fibrosis, and then cirrhosis. Although there are treatments available for hepatitis, a small percent of those with hepatitis B and about two-thirds of those infected with hepatitis C will develop chronic liver disease. The risk of cancer is also high among those with hepatitis C. As you ponder the consequences and causes of fatty liver and hepatitis, you should be thinking forward to identify how nutrition is impacted. With high risk of gastrointestinal problems and malnutrition, how would nutrition be impacted? What strategies could be used to improve nutrition? In what ways is nutrition able to prevent fatty liver or hepatitis?